Hi everybody. I'm going to show you how to make spaghetti without any carbs and basically without pasta. I got this idea from Rocky. I'll put her channel over in the side link. She did a video on how to make General Tso chicken without using pasta. What she used was spaghetti squash. Now I have made this dish quite a few times, so I've become comfortable enough to make this on video. So I hope you guys will find this really helpful. Now, you will want to use spaghetti squash if you're trying to stay away from carbs for dinner or lunch. And if any of you are familiar with my cooking videos, you would know that I cut carbs out of my dinner. So, and it's worked really well so far. But I am a pasta person, and this actually substitute for pasta really well in any type of pasta dish you would like. So let me show you how you make spaghetti squash, and I can promise you that if you make this, you will not miss pasta. All right, first, what you want to do, well, let me tell you, this cost me, I think, 99 cents per pound, and it was about 3 pounds typically. So they're not expensive. They're in an oval shape like this and of a yellow color. All right, so what you want to do is you want to pierce, I would say, about 4 to 5 holes. You want to put 4 to 5 holes in your squash, deep enough so that it reaches the center. I know y'all hate when I use my knife, but what I do is I kind of just cut a slit and I go down as far as I can, cut my slit. Okay, so I have 4 holes here. 1, 2, 3. Four, actually, I did five, and that's five right here, okay? So, the big terrific thing about this video is the spaghetti squash, but I'm actually just going to show you how I'm making my whole dish tonight, just for anybody else who would like to see it. Alright, I'm going to make spaghetti and meatballs. Typically, I make my meatballs from scratch, but I kind of got lazy this time around. So I'm going to use Fit Inactive turkey meatballs. Okay, I'm going to put this much. That should be good for now. Okay, so I'm going to put this in for 25 minutes. Anyway, so with these meatballs all done, I'm just going to put them into my spaghetti sauce. Oopsie. Okay, in my spaghetti sauce, just to let you guys know, I added in some onion powder, some garlic powder, some bell pepper, and like a quarter size, maybe even smaller chunk of brown sugar. Would it be healthier without the brown sugar? It sure would, but I make my red sauces with a little bit of brown sugar, except for my lasagna. Now it's very hot. It's not something you can go picking up. It's a cooked squash, people. So it's very hot, okay? All right. Now when I touch my squash, it is very soft. You can probably see it denting in. You want to see that. All right. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to first cut the bottom off because it makes it easier for me to hold. I'm going to cut this part off. And I need to use a paper towel to hold. Typically, you should wait 10 minutes to let it cool down so you don't burn your hands. I never do. I don't have a good reason why I don't. I'm just impatient. So here we go. It's all cut off. All right, I'm not sure if it's complete. Just cut it. Put it straight down the middle. And I'm going to show you the reason why This is called spaghetti squash. Alright. Now I'm gonna tell you right now. I was raised in a household that if you cook some type of squash or something with seeds in the middle, for example, a pumpkin, you keep those seeds, you rinse them off, you clean like all the membrane off of it, and you can cook, you can bake the seeds. So I actually save my seeds. It's like a nice tasty snack, and I might cook them up tomorrow or a couple days from tomorrow. And this little part here, once you cut that part off, if you were to taste it, you would see that this squash is even good by itself. Just as a side note, some people will even use spaghetti squash as like a dessert. They'll add butter and some sugar to it. You know, it's completely up to you what you want to do with it. I like to use it as pasta. So now we have our squash. And actually, if you were to look inside of it, you can see the strings, right? We are gonna get those strings out of there. So to do that, you want to pick up your squash. I'm using a paper towel because, like I said, I'm impatient and it's hot. You want to pick up your squash, and I'm going to try to do this left-handed, and you just scrape. Sorry, that's a chunk. Ignore that. Oh, I still got some seeds in here. You might come across some seeds. Not a big deal. All right. Anyway, you just want to scrape, and if you notice, it's coming off in long strings like this. Okay, and look, you can actually see it separating. I'm hoping you can see how it's stringy. Okay, and you just want to scrape it on down. Now you'll know it's not done because it won't be stringy. It'll come out in little short strands, kind of like rice, as Rocky described it. And then if it comes out like rice in shorter strands after like the first couple scrapes, it's okay. You can put it right back into the microwave. You want to just actually put the squash back together, wrap it up with some wax paper, I guess, and then just put it back in there for like another 5 minutes or so and just kind of test it out that way. But if you see, it all comes out in strings. It's actually in a string form even before you start scraping it, okay? You just want to use a fork because you want to assist in the stringiness of the squash. Okay, I'm going to keep scraping. I'm going to flip this over to the other side because I'm not left-handed. And just get it all out. Okay? Okay. Let me show you how this looks. It looks like pasta, doesn't it? Look at that. Let me pick one up for you. See? Looks like pasta. Alright, and you can just separate a little bit more in the pile. Don't be rough, you don't want to go chopping it up. And they're not very delicate, the strands, to let you know, they're not delicate at all. Actually, when you first scrape them out, they feel harder. It might feel like it's not completely done, okay? Because it might feel a little bit harder. But once you eat them, they're not like that at all. Okay, so I'm going to scrape this other half. I have my pasta, I just pick up and put it into the bowl. And it picks up like clumps, but once you eat it, I mean, you can't swirl it around like spaghetti, but, you know. Okay, there it is. It's just like spaghetti and meatballs. Okay, mixing it up. And honestly, I'm not the one to substitute many things with other stuff, I mean, I try to when it comes to being healthy, but sometimes I just don't like it. But this right here, you know, definitely hits the spot, and you don't miss pasta when you do this.